it then.
This place holds even more secrets than we thought.
Get him!
did something.
So, it isn't a dead end after all.
Apparently not.
Room.
And look what's in it. How old do you suppose this is? 1,000 years? More?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like it before. Who is that in the middle, do you think? Some sort of god. You're him. The second dominant of fire. Who are you? Joshua chose me to be his shield. He gave me his blessing and asked me to keep him safe. I should have protected him that day. It was my duty.
Sorry. I failed. you.
Joshua died. I killed him.
And I blamed another for what I did. To spare myself the guilt.
I feared the Bai. Accepting it, I would lose what little was left of me.
So I ran. From everything.
And now? Are you ready to accept the truth?
I am.
I know it won't be easy, but it's what I must do. So that Joshua's soul can finally rest in peace.
Look!
deny it. Even when the truth's staring right at you. Come on, Clive. Face your fears.
Yeah.
escape, eh? It's all right. I'm done running from you. Together, then. It's time to find out who we are, once and for all.
Clive, are you all right?
Jill. It's nothing. I'll be fine. No more chasing shadows. The hooded man isn't here. We should go.
Clive, are you sure you're all right? Whatever it is, you can tell me.
I had a hard enough time telling myself. I awakened as a dominant of fire, right here in this castle, and I've been running from it ever since. But now I know for certain who I really am. The second Eikon of Fire, who killed my brother and burned this castle to the ground, was me. Ifrit.
Clive.
I took so many lives that night, and destroyed so many more, including yours. And I must atone for the crimes I've committed, but not before I learn the whole truth. How can a second Eikon of Fire even exist? And why was I chosen as its dominant? Who is the hooded man who brought us here? And what does he want? I need to know. And since I'm still breathing, I might as well make myself useful.
We'll find your answers together. I want to learn the truth too. There'll be time enough for atonement when we're done.
I was hoping you'd say that. I don't think I could do this without you. You never were one to hide from the truth, even when we were young. And you haven't changed a bit.
You're wrong. I have changed. But I don't want to be that person anymore. The things she did were unforgivable. And yet, they're what brought us back together.
Thank you, Jill.
If he is here, then the disturbance I felt at the care must have been confounded. The hour is later than I thought.
Who delivered the coffer said, he said Sid paid him.
No! muck with the rest of your rats, and this is how you repay me? Find out where he is. I'll crush him, flay him, rip out his heart, him and all his filthy brood, and send every last one of them to hell. Out. Now!
Yes, yes, my lord.
So, what next?
We return to Eastpool. I promised the mayor I'd talk to him again. About Lady Hannah, amongst other things. Though she may be loath to leave, I can't help thinking she'd be safer with Sid too.
All right. We should arrange an introduction. Then. Torgal. What is it?
Nothing good, I'll wager. Come on.
For this.
Ah, we've got a live one.
Remember our orders? No survivors.
Who would order such a thing?
You know what to do.
Who sheltered them. By Empress Annabella's command!
I'm not out of this.
Clive.
I know. Quite. Sick of Torgal. Get a boy. Sick of Torgal.
Sorry, Lady Anna. You deserved so much better. All of these people did. Better than my mother.
Too late!
Gav!
Clive!
Acting on the orders of the Duchess, eh?
We knew Eastpool was harboring bearers. Thought they were safe enough hidden up here, but someone must have let slip.
If they'd have only come to us sooner, none of this would have had to happen. Fuck!
My mother always did despise bearers. The way father embraced them when the other nations spat on them as slaves. The way an accident of birth gave them a power that others lacked.
But why kill everyone? They meant no harm. They just wanted to be free.
This world judges that a crime punishable by death. Which is why we're going to change it. Gav, we want to help.
Thought you'd got your own stuff to be getting on with.
We do. But it can wait.
In that case, we should head back and tell Sid you've had a change of heart. He was always on it yet to join us.
All right.
And we'd best be quick. Last I heard, he was planning another excursion.
What about the villagers?
Oi! Can I leave you's lot to take care of things here?
Of course. We'll make sure they get a proper burial.
Thank you. All of you.
When you're ready, then.
Now, rats, lead me to your nest. Lord Kuka has a message for your leader. If only he knew where to send it.
Sid Sola, then. We have a lot to discuss.
Look what the curl dragged in.
If you're gonna buy some, be quick about it. Finished, are you?
Well? What do you want? Anything else?
I heard Otto barking at his lot earlier. Didn't sound happy.
Don't mind me. Just taking a quick breather, innit?
I can set a broken arm, soothe a cough, settle a stomach. But there is no remedy for what happened in Eastpool. My talents are worthless in the face of such cruelty. We can keep running, or we can walk through this door.
This place is getting more crowded by the day.
I tell myself the bustle's a blessing. There'll be time enough for quiet contemplation when I'm dead. So, did you find the answers you were looking for?
I still don't know what to make of this gift, curse, or whatever it is I've been given. But there is one thing I can say for certain. I am a dominant, Ifrit. And there is nothing I can do to change that. It is a burden I must bear until my dying day.
Spoken true. Forgiveness, and in turn salvation, can only begin with acceptance. It's a path we all must walk, no matter how colorful our histories.
Sid, you once told me that you wanted to build a place where people could die on their own terms.
I did.
I've been thinking about that. Why not a place where people can live on their own terms? For 13 years, killing was all I knew. So obsessed with death that I never stopped to consider the lives of those around me. Lives that I see now were scarcely worth living. Be they bearers or beggars, most march blindly to their end, never realizing that they too deserve a choice. And I dare not turn a blind eye to their suffering any longer.
So, atonement then, is it?
That was the answer we found.
The only one we need.
I'll be expecting you both to pull your weight.
And we will.
Well then, with a sprinkle of fire and ice, this plan of mine might just work.
What trouble are you looking to get yourself into now?
The best kind. We're going to sneak into the Imperial capital and pay a visit to Mother.
And the last of our farmholds in the eastern provinces has succumbed to the Blight. Without their yield, we will be hard-pressed to fill the capital's granaries before winter.
If there is a capital by then, the Black creeps closer as we speak.
And yet you do naught but bawl and bluster.
Your Radiance?
If it is fertile land the Empire requires, we need but look south.
If you mean the crystalline Dominion's holdings, we are bound by mutual accord. Theirs is a neutral state whose borders we are sworn to respect.
Gentlemen, did we swear to see our people starve?
Well, I really do think that...
The gates of Oriflam buckle at the flood of those come seeking refuge from the Blight. If there is not grain enough to feed those within our walls, how, pray tell, will we feed those without? But instead of setting your minds to riddles such as these, you lock horns with an enemy from across the sea, sending our soldiers to the slaughter in their thousands. The Empire bleeds, and you sit here prattling like crones in a tea house. And you fancy yourselves leaders of men. Sandbreck is naught without her citizens. We are but their servants. If their land is being wrested away, it is our duty to claim new lands for them.
Your Radiance! You cannot mean a war of conquest.
That is exactly what I mean. It is time we expanded our dominion. This is the will of Great Grieger.
There will be uproar.
Then we must find a way to distract the citizenry.
But how much will that cost?
And what of our legions? Shall we raise the thirds?
Well, someone will have to contend with the Delmex.
I will not keep you. You all have much to do. Where is my son?
The Lord Prince is currently garrisoned at the Strait of Arthur. If it please you, I can send word requesting his immediate return to the Holy Capital.
That won't be necessary. Tell him instead to see to his wounds. Bahamut's strength will be needed again soon.
As you command.